Children, I hope you have remembered what we have discussed in the previous class. Yes, zeros of polynomial and few examples on it. So today we are going to discuss about remainder theorem. Now dividing the polynomials. Now let us consider an example and see how we can divide a polynomial by any non-zero polynomials. Let us consider a polynomial P of x is equal to 3x square plus x minus 1 and a non-zero polynomial g of x is equal to x plus 1. Now divide a polynomial P of x by g of x. 3x square plus x minus 1 divided by x plus 1. X plus 1 is called divisor. 3x square plus x minus 1 is dividend. 3x minus 2 is a quotient and 1 is the remainder. Now let us see the dividing process. Let us divide first term of the dividend by the first term of the divisor. What is the first term of dividend here? 3x square and first term of divisor is x. So 3x square by x is 3x. Now multiply x plus 1 into 3x. You will get here 3x square plus 3x. Now subtract 3x square plus 3x from 3x square plus x. While subtracting, you have to change the symbols. Plus 3x square will become minus 3x square and plus 3x will become minus 3x. Plus 3x square and minus 3x square will cancel. And plus x and minus 3x will get here minus 2x. Bring minus 1 down and the same process continues again. The first term of the dividend is minus 2x and the first term of the divisor is x. Minus 2x by x is minus 2. Now multiply x plus 1 into minus 2. You will get minus 2x and minus 2. Now let us subtract it. Then plus, let us subtract by changing the symbols. Minus 2x will become plus 2x and minus 2 will become plus. Here plus 2x and minus 2x will cancel and you will get here 0. And minus 1 plus 2 you will get answer as 1, which is the remainder. We stop here as the remainder is 1. The division process is said to be completed if we get the remainder 0. Or the degree of remainder is less than the degree of divisor. Yet degree of remainder is what here? For constant 1, the degree of remainder is 0. And what is the degree of divisor there? The degree of divisor is 1. So the process will stop till here. Now let us write the division fact for this. So what is the division fact for this? Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Dividend is 3x square plus x minus 1. Divisor is x plus 1 and quotient is 3x minus 2 and remainder is 1. So if P of x and g of x are two polynomials here, means 3x square plus x minus 1 and x plus 1 are two polynomials, such that degree of P of x is greater than or equal to degree of g of x. What is the degree of P of x here? Degree of P of x is 2, which is greater than degree of g of x is 1, which is greater than P of x. And g of x is not equal to 0. Then we will get Q of x and R of x. So here we say that when P of x is divided by a g of x, gives Q of x as a quotient and R of x as a remainder. So children, in the above example, the divisor was a linear polynomial x plus 1. So in such situations, let us see if there is any link between the remainder and a certain value of the dividend. Like P of x is equal to 3x square plus x minus 1. Now if we replace x is equal to minus 1, we have P of minus 1 is equal to 3 into minus 1 square plus minus 1 and minus 1. Means here we have replaced minus 1 in a place of x. So minus 1 whole square is 1. And 3 into 1 is 3. Plus minus 1 is minus 1. Minus 1. Minus 1 and minus 1 will become minus 2. So 3 minus 2 is equal to 1. So children, what do you observe here? The remainder obtained on dividing a polynomial p of x is equal to 3x square plus x minus 1 by x plus 1 is same as p of minus 1, where p minus 1 is a 0 of the polynomial x plus 1, that is x minus x is equal to minus 1. Means when you are dividing a polynomial 3x square plus x minus 1 by x plus 1, what you got there? Remainder 1. And when you are substituting in a place of x minus 1, then you are getting the remainder 1. So both are same. Now from the above example, we shall now state the fact in a form of the following theorem. It gives a remainder without actual division of a polynomial by a linear polynomial in one variable. Now let us generalize this. Dividend is equal to divisor into quotient plus remainder. Dividend is p of x, divisor is x minus a, quotient is q of x, and the remainder is r. If we have a polynomial p of x, and if we divide by a linear divisor x minus a, we will get quotient as q of x and remainder as r. Now we need to substitute x is equal to a. Now p of a is equal to a minus a into q of a plus r. A minus a is 0 into q of a plus r. 0 into q of a means the entire part will become 0. So p of a is equal to 0 plus r. P of a is equal to r. So p of a gives us the value of the remainder. So this is the remainder theorem. So if we divide a polynomial p of x by x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. That is, the value of this polynomial at x is equal to a is a remainder of this division. Let us see the statement of remainder theorem. Let p of x be a polynomial of degree greater than or equal to 1, and let a be a real number. If p of x is divided by a linear polynomial x minus a, then the remainder is p of a. This is the statement of remainder theorem. So children, it is not a simple way to find the remainder by dividing a polynomial by a linear polynomial. So using the remainder theorem, you can calculate the remainder even without dividing. Now let us see one example how to find a remainder without dividing. Let us see one example. Find a remainder when a polynomial x power 4 plus x cube minus 2x square plus x plus 1 is divided by x minus 1. Solution. Let us consider polynomial p of x, which is equal to x power 4 plus x cube minus 2x square plus x plus 1. So what is the 0 of the linear polynomial here? For x minus 1 is 1. Means x minus 1 is equal to 0, then x will become 1. Now replace x by 1. So p of 1 is equal to 1 power 4 plus 1 cube minus 2 into 1 square plus 1 and plus 1. And 1 power 4 is 1 plus 1 cube is 1. 1 square is 1. So minus 2 into 1 is minus 2. Plus 1 plus 1. You will get here 4 minus 2. 4 minus 2 is 2. So p of 1 is equal to 2. So by remainder theorem, 2 is the remainder when a polynomial x power 4 plus x cube minus 2x square plus x plus 1 is divided by x minus 1. Children, you can also check this by actual dividing a polynomial p of x by x plus 1. Then you will get the same remainder as 2. Okay children, So, okay children, today I have covered a reminder theorem and then an example related to reminder theorem. And I hope so you have enjoyed this class and you will complete the given assignment. That's all for today and have a great learning. Thank you.